Member for Prince George McKenzie.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. The police in Canada are amongst the best trained in the world. They spend their days focused on the very small percentage of our populations who are the worst behaved citizens in our communities, people who commit such unspeakable acts against others that the average person cannot begin to comprehend, and people who lie, cheat, steal, and take advantage of the vulnerable. And police do this under the rigors of a strong constitution and charter of rights and freedoms and complex technical investigative requirements. They do this with compassion, with empathy, and professionalism. They do this under extreme scrutiny from the public, from the courts, and from the myriad of oversight agencies, tribunals, and police boards. The burden our police agencies carry today is immense. It often places them as first responders to societal disorder perpetuated by untreated mental illness and addictions, by domestic frustrations triggered by unemployment, from housing needs, from health needs, or a myriad of other needs. And yet, Mr. Speaker, they do it. They do their jobs every second of every minute of every day with undiminished professionalism. They do it by placing themselves in harm's way to protect the public. Mr. Speaker, this is National Police Week 2021, and our police agencies in BC are advocating for a more collaborative approach, a more integrated effort amongst all police services, social agencies, and the public, in providing a modernized approach to address not only the criminal aspects of policing that comprise about 30% of police agencies' file load, but the social disorder that comprises 70% of a police agency's workload. On behalf of this House, I would like to thank all dedicated men and women across the Great Province who put their uniform on every day to keep our citizens safe and to help those less fortunate navigate through the tragedies and misfortune.